hasn't he done us proud? All of us have been following the journey of Jeff Horn's training. He has never trained so hard for this game of his life with the fight on Sunday against the legendary Manny Pacquiao. Look at that support. This event is going to put Brisbane on the map. The Battle of Brisbane has delivered. We're going to have a sellout crowd at Suncorp Stadium. And news just in today is that our hotels are at more than 90% occupancy. So we've seen that if you're trying to get a hotel room in Brisbane, it's almost impossible now with more than 90% of our hotels sold out. There is also still tickets available though. So if you want to be part of the action, Ticketek still has some tickets available from just $39. And I'm calling on all Queenslanders and Australians that if you can get to the boxing fight on Sunday, you should be there. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to be part of something that is truly magical. This is the largest boxing match ever to be held in Australia, and it's happening here with the Battle of Brisbane. So Jeff, we want to say to you as a proud Queenslander and as the Minister for Education, you're a teacher, that you have done us all so proud. You have trained so hard. You are absolutely embodies what it means to be a Queenslander. We're all going to be there cheering for you. I kept my orange dress for Sunday.
Thanks, Kate. I really appreciate all the support I've had from you and Graham Quirk and everyone else that have put in for this fight. It's going to do amazing things for Brisbane. It's putting us right on the map, and I cannot wait for Sunday. We're nearly there, only a couple more sleeps to go. I've got that weight making process to do now, so I'm going to go relax, try and get that out of my mind, and then I'm straight onto that fight with Manny Pacquiao, and it's going to be a blockbuster, I promise.
Jeff, what's it mean to you to have all these hundreds of fans here supporting you along the way?
Well, it's a lot different. This is kind of what I got to turn up to some of my last fights, let alone just a press conference in the city. But it's an amazing turnout. It just shows the support that Queensland are giving to this. And I really appreciate every single person coming out here today and showing their support. And I'm going to do my rounds and come around and say hello to a few of them soon. Yeah, the nerves are fine at the moment. Like I said, I've got to make weight. Once I get that process probably done on Saturday, then I'll start thinking about the fight more. The nerves will creep in. I think it's always good to have a little bit of nerves because that just keeps me on edge. But I'll be trying to contain them as much as possible because I don't want it to drain my energy either.
Your family,
yeah, definitely. The family's definitely keeping me grounded. They talk to me and treat me as normally as possible. I have them around me just to keep me calm. I've got a great family behind me. They're in the sheds before this and just talking to me like we always do.
Jeff, this is probably the fifth or sixth time you've been asked this week, but are you good enough to knock Manny Pacquiao out?
Definitely. If I can land the right shot on Manny Pacquiao, he will go to sleep. Now, I don't say that disrespectfully as in I'm definitely going to knock Manny Pacquiao out, but if I land that shot, he's going to go down. Yes, so I'm sitting at 70.3, so it's about 3.5-4 kilos over at the moment. I will lose that. That's probably a more comfortable drop than what I'm even used to. I'm used to dropping for about 71 kilos, so this is going to be a lot easier, and I'm going to feel strong, and I'm going to feel bigger than Manny, because I know he's probably sitting around the weight, so yeah, hopefully that's an advantage for me.
How do you feel today?
I feel good. I feel strong. I'm in my tapering stage, so I'm doing less and less training per day. So the body's starting to feel fresh again, and I'm almost ready at my peak to get in there again on Sunday.
Jeff, through all your press conferences, etc., you've remained very calm and very dignified. At some point, you have to let the dog off the leash. Can you talk us about how you transition, when you transition to get into fight mode?
Yeah, the transition, so when those nerves are going to really pick up, he's going to be in the dressing rooms probably just before the fight. I'm going to feel those nerves, probably even, as I said, straight after weigh-in, I'll start thinking about it a lot more, and then turning up to the venue and all that. It's going to really make me feel, the fight's actually happening and it's here, and hearing that crowd roaring.
And have you got any superstitions or any routines that you always go through?
No, there's no superstitions or routines. I just like being on schedule. So Manny being late the other day probably wasn't the best thing, but waking up at a certain time and eating at a certain time throughout the day. So 8 o'clock, I'm going to wake up on fight day, just so I'm feeling nice and fresh still at 1:30 or 2 o'clock when I fight.
One for the promoters as well, Jeff. It's good to see that it's going to be the most viewed ever Australian fight on pay-per-view. That's pretty special for you.
Yeah, it's absolutely amazing exposure that Brisbane, Queensland and all the sponsoring the event are going to get. Even, I don't know, like the amount of exposure for this is amazing. So hopefully we get a lot more traction in Brisbane and people will think of Brisbane rather than Melbourne and Sydney sometimes. Yeah, and make sure everyone books early for this fight because it's trending to be a sellout on main event and it's going to be very busy. So if you want to watch the fight at home, make sure you book it prior to the day, because it could crash on Sunday.
Hey Jeff, you mentioned something about Manny arriving late to the press conference. As someone who likes to be punctual, like as a former school teacher, did that bother you at all?
Look, it was frustrating. I think I was more frustrated for Kate and Graham and other people that actually had appointments on after that. I had training as well, which was holding that up. So I like to be on schedule, as you said, when the bell rings. I like to be in class on time, like my students. So, it was a bit frustrating, but what can you do? He's the man of the show at the moment.
Dean actually took a light shot at Manny for texting, and did that bother you at all? Like, he's not taking the event seriously?
Well, it was hilarious when Dean called him out, my promoter from Juco Events. He said, look, Manny's a professional texter as well, and Manny was like, put his phone down. It was hilarious watching his reaction to that one.
Freddie Roach has come out and said that the biggest danger of Manny Pacquiao was the flight over here. What's your response to Freddie Roach?
I guess it's always hard doing the long travel flight time, but Manny's arrived here plenty of time early to get accustomed to the Brisbane time zone and our weather, so I don't think that's going to be an excuse for this fight.
What about when he said that his advice for you is to stay home on Sunday?
Well, that won't be happening, will it?
No, I definitely won't be staying home on Sunday. It won't be a sick day, that's for sure. I'll be turning up on the event, and no matter what Freddie says, I'm going to give it my all, and I think that's going to be enough. He might not think so, but he should, because he's a trainer. He should be looking at everything of mine.
See you Sunday.
See you Sunday.
Thanks, Chris. Yeah. Thanks.